All right, so we are back outside of my garage. So today I swapped an opener on the small door, and I'm also going to have basically an update on the LDC0850, how it's running and what I've thought of it so far. So we're going to go inside. We're going to start by running up the big door with the MTR3. And we're going to run up the small door with the same MTR3. So here's the opener I installed on the small door, is the linear LDO50. I thought it'd be kind of cool to have two matching openers. Well, not matching openers, but kind of cool to have matching brands on both doors, linear on the small door and a linear on the big door. This LD50, it's a good machine, a little noisy, but I mean, it's not like they're supposed to be. It's not like they're designed to be a quiet opener anyway. So yeah, I mean, this thing runs really well. This rail is a full rail, proper full rail, also chain drive. This is the older rail because the turnbuckle is not right next to the trolley. As you can see, the turnbuckle is up towards the front on this side. Probably can't see it on the newer rails. The turnbuckle is right by the trolley there. So, yeah, this LD50 is a great machine. This is one I got a few years ago at work. It's not brand new, but I have a box for it. So, I've got this is the wall control that I got with it. This remote is one of the remotes I got with it. And the keychain remote I have for it is this. This is a linear model ACT-31B. Little single button remote. It is compatible with this opener. So, it's, like I said, it's a little noisy, but it does definitely get the job done. Oh, by the way, yes, I know I don't have a handle for this rope. Didn't have one when I got the rail. So, anyway, let's run this. And I believe the reason they changed the turnbuckle is because it would catch on the trolley if the chain's too loose, because that was happening when I first put this up. The chain was too loose and the trolley was catching on the turnbuckle, setting the force off. So, probably is why they changed that. So, yeah, there's the LDO50. Arm's out a little. Maybe could have brought the arm out a little bit, but it doesn't matter. So, as for how this thing's been doing, so far, I've loved it. It's been installed for about a year and a half. This thing is still quieter than the 8550 ever was. It's not nearly as quiet as it was when I first put it in, but still quieter than a LiftMaster would be. I know one of the things I was complaining about was that the lighting wasn't great, but honestly, well, we have those lights back there that we use as work lights. And I mean, honestly, one of these times when it's night out, I'll show you the lighting on this. It's really actually not that bad. It's plenty of light to be able to see what you're doing. I mean, if I wanted something brighter, I would get an 863, which is 4,000 lumens, two times as bright as an 87504. Let's see. It does have that weird thing with the battery backup. Don't know if the current linears still do that. I would kind of think not. I don't have a new, like, current day linear. I think they're pretty much the exact same electronics as this, so who knows if it still does that. That's the only real issue I've had with it, and it's not even that big of a deal since we don't get power outages here very often. The other thing was with the remote range, but I found out it was because of the LEDs we had outside. So remotes are fine. It's not quite as good range as the 8550 got, but it's still good enough. I mean, you can open the door from plenty far away. I feel like it's It's worked pretty much flawlessly since I put it in. It's a great machine. Now the other thing that I did, you can see we actually have a green light. So I actually hooked this opener up to Wi-Fi and tested out the app. I will show you that later in the video. So the app, it's not as, the interface isn't quite as nice as the MyQ app, but they're not, they don't have advertisements all over the app to get you to buy freaking MyQ cameras and Amazon Key and stuff. And it wasn't, I mean, I don't really think it was any harder to set up than MyQ. You pretty much, you've got a Wi-Fi, these LEDs are so bright. You've got a Wi-Fi learn button there that you push, and then you, the app pretty much walks you through it. Once you push the Wi-Fi learn button, you connect to the Wi-Fi connection built into this. You type in your Wi-Fi password, then you connect to that Wi-Fi network again to finish setting it up. I mean, it's pretty quick. It doesn't really take any longer than setting up MyQ does, so. All right, well, I guess let's run this linear here, the cycle with this remote. And back up. So yeah, that is a very quiet machine. All right, we'll run up this LDO50 again here. Let's use a keychain remote, actually. So what I'll do here, I'll get you a noise comparison between the DC linear and the AC linear so you can hear just how quiet this LDCO850 is. So let's start with the LDO50. LDCO850. You can hear just a slight bit of motor noise from the LDCO850, but it's practically dead silent. All you really hear is the chain in the door. So, all right, we'll give you a sensor and force test on each opener. Also, I discovered something kind of interesting on this LDO50. So the linears do stop going down, and if you stop this LDO50 going down, it actually runs up just a tiny bit. And I feel like that's probably just to try to keep it from drifting or something, but if you watch kind of close, well, here, maybe it'll be easier if I show you with the remote. So here we go. You might be able to see it bump up just a tiny little bit. I think that's to try to keep it from drifting. It's kind of interesting. Anyway, we'll give you a sensor and force test on both openers, starting with the LDO50. I didn't already mention, I am using my LiftMaster sensors. I don't know why it looks like it's flashing, it's not, but I am using those because they do work. I didn't feel like rigging up my linear eyes. Give it a force test. Force on it worked great. And then we'll show it to you on this LDCO850 here. That one does beep. And then we'll get you a force test here. Again, force is very sensitive. Beeps three, or does three times for the sensors, four times for the force. All right, we'll get you battery backup test on this linear here. And then I'll show you the Wi-Fi on it. So unplug it. Now, one of the things that I like, you see, the light is still on. See, those LEDs are still on, even in battery backup mode. Something LiftMaster should do, but they don't do it. So anyway, let's get you a battery backup test. For some reason on the first push, it just clicks. The other thing that I love is that the linear doesn't beep the whole time when it's in battery backup mode. Sorry for not holding the camera straight. I don't know why it beeped. But run it up. Again, you can hear it's pretty much just dead silent. So I do like that it doesn't beep the whole time when you run it. I don't know why LiftMasters do that. It's completely unnecessary to have that. Okay, last thing I'll show you is the Wi-Fi on it. So, let me open it up here. All right. So, let's run it. Oh. Operate the door using wall stage. I have to cycle it fully. I mean error because I tripped the sensors. See anything yet? Oh, I think I have to run a full cycle. Alright. See if that cleared it. Really? Hold on, maybe I just have to reopen the app. Possibly. I don't know. Really? Hold up. Maybe I just need to reset the Wi-Fi. So here's what's this little button here on the right. Resyncs the Wi-Fi. So now it's just going to go through some flashing lights here. That's solid green, that means it is connected. So now let's see. Offline. Still not going. Oh, there it goes. The other thing I like, it doesn't beep the entire time when it closes like the LiftMasters do. That's the other nice thing, by the way, is you can reset the Wi-Fi just by pushing a button. On the LiftMasters, you can't really reset the Wi-Fi. You have to clear the whole thing and reprogram it again. So, yeah. And then I do still have the side button over here. I didn't already mention that. And then the keypad over here. So yeah, this opener's been great. And I don't see any reason why I should go back to a LiftMaster. So, I mean, let me know in the comments if you like Lanier or not. Except, don't be the kind of person that says, I don't care what you have to say, Lanier sucks. Because one, way to be an asshole about it, and two, you're just going to say Lanier sucks without giving any context that, for all I know, you've never touched a Lanier, you just say it sucks because you haven't tried it. So, let me know if you've had issues with Lanier, what kind of issues you've had, or if they've worked good for you, let me know. Just want to hear. But I mean, I don't see why I should go back to a LiftMaster, because I've loved this machine, it's worked great. So, anyway, that's it. I've been talking for long enough, so, and I got one other video I have to make today, so, well, that I want to make today, so, we'll see you guys later.